here we are again from the Princeton Nano Brewery, and I'm going to make a Courage Best Bitter kit beer. Part 2 of the plan. Now, what comes in one of these kits? Instructions, don't need them. Yeast, don't need that. 2 cans of malt, which we do need, and they've already been in hot water for feels like decades, to be honest. Not overly happy. As an aside, auto siphons. Young's auto siphon. Utter rubbish. If you can get the clip to stay on, I'll be amazed. When you come to try and clean it, if the little bit of plastic comes out of the bottom, you're hosed, because it'll no longer auto-siphon. Chuck it in the bin. In fact, don't even buy it. Save your money and buy just a piece of siphon tubing. Rubbish, in my opinion. Absolute rubbish. A waste of however much it was. I don't care. Rant over with. Anyway, right. Deep breaths. Maybe a little annoying. Ah, here we are. So, after you've had your 2 cans of malt sitting in hot water, I use water from straight from the tap, as hot as it will come. After it's been sitting in there for an absolute decade, when you've been dicking around with your auto siphon, I'm not letting it back the rest yet. Open your tins of malt. Have about 3 liters, it's a kettle full of water. Ready. Just put it on to boil again. It has boiled once, but it wants to be boiling, as near boiling as possible. Fermentation bucket, big spoon. Not an awful auto siphon from Young's. Like I said that once. So, taking care to avoid your spoon. Tip your cans of malt into the fermentation bucket. Now, when your water's boiling, spin that round to try and stop as many good ones as possible. Catch it in there like that. A bit of a grill on the lid, but that shouldn't matter too much. Boiling water. The way I do it, I'm not sure if you can see that, so I'll just tilt it down a little bit. Bring you forward a little bit so I can actually reach it. Put you down. Right. Tip the boiling water onto the lid so that some of it flows into the fermentation bucket, but some of it actually goes into the can as well. Until the lid is clean. As you can see, most of the malt has gone from the back of the lid. Pull that to one side. Do exactly the same again with the next can. This time, after the lid's clean, preferably put it down first with big raising fingers. pour the rest of the kettle into the can. Now, it's not going to quite fill the can, but then you want to stir. It's better if you get the can full of water. But that's just how it goes on washing the lids. So you're just rinsing the malt from the top of the can into the liquor below. Next, take a damp cloth. You're better not doing this in the sink. See that? That's awful. Another reason why you don't take the lids off completely, just leave about a centimetre, 10 millimetres. So you can hold it and guide it and keep it for as long as possible before it starts burning your fingers through the cloth, which is really great. Pour as much as you can in. That results in, don't know if that's focused or not, but virtually all of them are from the can. So it's the same as this can. This can already has some water in it, so it's fuller. If anything, I put a bit much in it, but I was panicking because it was slightly choking down the fingers. Exactly the same process. Wrap the cloth round. Once you've got a good grip, use the lid to steady it. Pack it into the fermenter. And again, perfectly clean can. Stir all the malt up. Mixed with the water, the hot water. Then you remove your rubbish auto siphon from the jar that you want, from the jug that you want. Chuck it on the floor if you don't care. Now you have, it's about 20 pints of cold water. Give it here. These are about 2.5 pints. About 10 of them. Just then we get to about half the water in. And then you're going to give it a good aeration. That'll do for the aeration. Make sure you snap your spoon in half and leave half in for added flavour. Right. I didn't like that spoon anyway, it was rubbish. top up with your amino acid. Chuck your yeast in and put it away. Not having a good day. Right, I'll leave you there. Young's Auto Cycle, rubbish. Plastic spoons, rubbish. Not having a good day. Basically top it up to 23 litres. Chuck your starter in, check the specific gravity, check its temperature, write all your details down, and go off in a huff. Right, cheers, and have some beer. I'll see you next time. Later.